is a presentation of TFNN. The Tom O'Brien Show is produced every business day. Tom takes your phone calls toll-free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Let's go to Dell in Texas. Hey, Dell, what's going on?
Hey, Tom.
How you doing, man?
My call. Great.
Thanks for calling. Thanks for holding. Appreciate it.
I love your show. I just stumbled upon it probably, I don't know, maybe a month ago.
And how'd you find us?
I found you on YouTube.
YouTube. That's a beautiful thing. Well, we appreciate you growling and prowling with us. Welcome to the Tiger family, man.
Wow.
I like it. Totally.
Now, Tom O'Brien.
Welcome, folks. This is Tom O'Brien of TFNN. We go 5 days a week. We go 10 hours a day. We go 24 hours a day on the internet at TFNN.com. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. Hope everyone's having a great day, safe day. Let's make it a great night, folks. Heal yourself and your relationships will heal too. If you can heal yourself, then you're going to be ready to have a relationship without fear, without need. If you and your partner each work on yourselves, you will see how quickly progress is made. Market wise, let's take a look at it out here. We have the Dow Industrials up 68, NASDAQ up 15, S&P's up 8.5, gold contract up $16.80, traded at $1,263 an ounce. Silver up 66 cents at $17.06 an ounce. Platinum up 11 bucks at $10.10 an ounce. Copper up a penny at $2.06 a pound. Light sweet crude up 81 cents, trading at $51.18 a barrel. Bonds, you get the 10-year note flat. 130.30, 30-year bond up 15, 166.30. Both the 10 and the 30, folks, are building cars to go up and break their all-time highs. King dollar down 267 ticks, trading at 93.56. King dollar going south, building more cars to get down into the low of 91.88. The euro is trading at $1.13, up 40 ticks, and the yen is at 106, down 42 ticks. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. Give us a call, folks. Want to know what's going on in your world. In the world of the S&Ps, let's take a look at them. What do you have? We look at the SPY first. What you're going to see here is this. The SPY is at 212.41. You've done 45 million shares out here. Yesterday, we did 60 million. We bring this baby back. What you're going to see is that it is slowly and surely making it up to the high. And the high that we're talking about from 2015 is 213.78, and we're just about there. If we take a look at the cash S&P, what you're going to see is that the cash S&P, and the cash S&P needs 14 more points. And the reason that cash S&P would be a better indication is because it doesn't trade. So that number gets generated by the amount of equities that are traded inside the S&P 500. Now, we are 2120. And it's 2134.72. The thing that's pretty wild is that the low of the high we're into right now, the low of the high of May 22nd, the week of May 22nd of 2015, is 2120.01. So we're into it. I expect that thing's going to get hit the next couple of days. NDX 100. Let's take a look at the NDX 100. Now, the NDX 100 is a little bit different. Not as strong. Right now, the Qs are up 28 cents. We're at $110.46. I do expect they're going to at least try to test the April 19th level, high, that is. That's $111.44. We'll see how it handles that level. Bottom line, you've been here we've been here 6 days on a sideways move. If we go over to the Russell 2000, we take a look at the IWM. What you're going to see in the IWM, right now it's up a dollar. We're at 118.57. And when you do pull this back, this is making the run for $120.07. The $120.07 is the high that was generated the week of December 4th of 2015. The actual high in this, what I don't think it's going to get to, is 129.10. Gold contract. What do we have with gold? Gold folks wants higher price. We've done 164,000 contracts out here today. You have the price spread. You have the volume, all of the above. And we're trading at the 1263.70. Gold's making that run for the high that was generated out here on the 2nd of May, which is the 1308. We go to the bond market. We take a look at bonds. What you're going to see in the bond market is this. 10-year note out here. 10-year note out here is flat today. We are hanging right at these highs. Volume is light out here today. You have the volume right now is trading at 130.30. I mean, with volume is 714,000 contracts, which is light. The high of today is 131.02. The longer it hangs up at these highs, meaning, you know, stays right at these levels, the more probability is that it's going to launch the 131.07 area, which will bring notes and bonds to higher price, lower yield. Right now, the 10-year yield is 1.700. So the thing is ready to crack the 1.7. 30-year bond, what do we have with the 30-year? The same setup with the 30-year. 30-year, oh, this is interesting. So the 30-year actually is over this for today. So the 30-year right now is 166.30. Now, this would be a closing all-time high. If this is what we get coming into the close, which looks like it's gonna, that'd be a closing all-time high. That puts the 30-year bond, let's just see where this is at now. This is pretty amazing. 2.509. That's pretty amazing. There's no two ways about that. That is like over the top. King Dollar, what do we have with King Dollar? King Dollar, folks, can't hold price. King Dollar wants lower price. We've done 35,000 contracts out here today, and we're at 93.58. That King Dollar is making its way down into the May 3rd level. Now, the high of the low of May 3rd is 93.03. We hit 93.41 today. What I do expect you're going to see, though, is that we're going to get down into that level. The real key is going to be, is it going to blow that level away? Our phone number is 877-927-6648. We go over and we take a look at the XAU, the HUI. They both want higher price. This dollar is rocking, no doubt, the commodity market, folks. Lower dollar, higher commodity prices. The XAU out here is trading at $92.17. That's already into the bar from the high. The low of that bar is 89.67. We're at 92. The high is 93.66. I expect what you're going to see, more than likely, just going to blow that baby away in the next couple days. The Gold Bugs Index. Same setup in the Gold Bugs Index. What you have with the Gold Bugs Index is that the Gold Bugs Index right now is trading at $232.80. We've reached 237.09. The high was 236.26. So it's going to be intriguing here, and we won't get this until tonight, is that will there be a higher volume than where how we traded on the 2nd of May? At this point, I would suspect that we actually are not going to have higher volume inside the Gold Bugs Index, but it's a toss-up. And the reason I'm saying that I don't think we will, if you go over and look at some of the larger weighting structures, like Barrick Gold. Barrick Gold took out its high today. You're at $19.30. The high was 1950. You went to 1992, and it is going to have a lower volume. That being said, it's not backing off of these highs just yet. This is Tom O'Brien. This is TFNN. You stay right there, folks. We're coming right back. Dow Industrials right now are up 75. Nasdaq's up 17. S&P's are up 9.5. We're going to be right back.
If you're an active trader looking for that extra edge when it comes to trading and investments, then now is a great time to get a 2-week free trial to Tom O'Brien's daily market letter, Market Insights. Tom O'Brien's daily newsletter, Market Insights, comes out every market day at around 9:30 a.m. and provides Tom's daily commentary on the broad market, including the Dow, NASDAQ, and S&P, plus specific trade recommendations. There's even an update published most afternoons to keep you informed about the day's market activity. He'll give you the entry price, price target, and stop price of each stock and option trade. With Market Insights, there's nothing left to guessing. For all the details and to get your 2-week free trial to Market Insights started today, visit tfnn.com.
In quiet markets, investors search for new trading opportunities. We'd like to introduce you to a new product that provides opportunities even in flat markets. Nadex, the North American Derivatives Exchange, is a new and innovative Chicago-based exchange registered with the Commodity Futures Trading Commission. And unlike most other exchanges, Nadex allows you to trade directly through them with direct market access when using their trading platform. Nadex never charges a fee to use their platform, which even includes real-time charts and full customization capability. Nadex's unique short-term binary options allow traders and investors to capitalize on strategies even when the underlying markets are quiet. Nadex's innovation has allowed them to come up with a line of unique trading products that are unavailable anywhere else. See how it works at Nadex.com. That's Nadex.com, or click on the Nadex banner on the front page of TFNN.com. Futures and options trading involves risk and may not be appropriate for all investors. Until recently, it was almost impossible for the average investor to hedge against currency risk in Europe or Japan. For a bold trade on Europe or Japan that protects against moves in currency, trade HEGE or HEGJ, two times currency hedged leveraged ETFs from Direction Investments. Visit directioninvestments.com today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Tom, take your phone calls now. Toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Welcome back, folks. The Dow right now is up 64. You get the Nasdaq up 15. S&Ps are up 8.5. And, you know, if we go over to Europe for a second and just, you know, good old Mario Draghi, okay, the European Central Bank president, you know, a few weeks ago announced that bottom line is that they are not only going to buy sovereign debt, they're going to buy corporate bonds. So this just started today, but check this out. This is going to be amazing to watch how this shakes out. Now, this is an article by Bloomberg. The ECB distorts credit markets with little to show for it. We learned a few things on Wednesday about the European Central Bank's plan to buy corporate bonds. There's no way they would be able to keep secret the identities of the companies whose bonds they are buying. Every purchase will push around the price for specific bonds. This program is vastly different and much less stimulative in the broad sense from buying sovereign debt or any other highly liquid asset. The European Central Bank embarked on its campaign to purchase investment-grade corporate debt to turbocharge the efforts to spur growth. It didn't take long until Bloomberg reporters uncovered some specific market-moving details. So check this out, folks. This is pretty wild. The bank was buying bonds, this is today, of Anheuser-Busch, InBev, Telefonica, and Simons, among others. Not surprisingly, now this is where this gets really wild, not surprisingly, prices on those specific bonds rose. If a trader realized that the European whale wants to buy, why not ride the wave? The European Central Bank is willing to pay high prices, so anyone who owns the bonds they want almost has an excellent chance of turning a profit. This dynamic has influenced the European market so much already that it's pushed down some corporate debt borrowing cost to record lows. Perversely, some company bond yields have turned negative, particularly for those companies whose debt is seen as a likely European Central Bank target. It has been unheard of to pay a corporation to borrow money, and yet here we go. The thing that's wild that you want to get out of this, folks, is this. Okay, so I'm going to go back to our own bonds here for a second. When you look at our bond market, right? What happens is that the negative rate structures around the world are incredible. Now, these negative rate structures that we talk about every day, you know, here at TFNN, we're talking the notes and the bonds of the countries. When we're saying United States, you know, France, Germany, Italy. The article that I was just reading you has to do with corporate debt. Now, what's going to happen here, which is just amazing, And by the way, hold on, inside that article too, you're not talking small money. You're talking $80 billion, if I can get this up again. It's a big number, folks. And that's $80 billion a month, I believe, they're buying. One second, let me just get this down a little bit further. I'll come back to that, but I'll get you that number. It's a big number. So what you have is that when you look at our rates are still astronomically high in the context of where rates, I suspect, are going to go. Because if you have, just picture this for a second, you have a European Central Bank. They're buying corporate debt. Well, what are the corporations going to do? The corporations, they're going to keep issuing as much debt as you can issue, because it's going to get down to the point, if you have free money, and then, in fact, you put on the other side of that, that someone actually may pay the opposite, meaning instead of the corporation paying interest, the person who gets the note will pay interest to them, which, in fact, is going to be the European Central Bank. Bottom line, it's a mess. And where does that come? Well, that's going to come back. Now let's go to the hard assets. If we go over to the gold market, let's do silver next. We take a look at silver. What you're going to see here is that this has put a fire underneath hard assets in a big way. Where silver today is up 65 cents. You have 70,000 contracts. You're at $17. This wants to make its run to $18. You know, when you just really start putting this together, it's like this fiat money, you know, people were worried about fiat money in 2000 and 2002, and that was the first run inside the commodity markets. What has happened now is, in that context, folks, the fiat money was out there, but it's like nothing like what we're talking about now as to monetizing debt, because that's what that is. It's monetizing debt, because what you will have is that the European Central Bank more than likely will never sell the bonds. They don't have to, okay? Because when you have the printing press, picture this for a second, you buy them, you take them off the market, that's monetizing debt. And if you monetize debt, at some point, okay, it just means that there's more paper. And if there's more paper out there, what does that do? That makes all assets, hard assets, worth more money, because there's more paper chasing a finite amount of hard assets, you know? Are there more hard assets every day? Yes, there are. But guess what? When you have the printing press is going a lot faster than specifically you can mine gold, mine silver, build houses. Pick a hard asset, folks. Bottom line, we're going to see it, I suspect, go up. And, you know, hopefully it won't go to the moon. Because if that's what you have, inflation will catch on. And when it catches on, they're trying to have it catch on. That's the ironic part of this whole deal. And what has happened is that it's not catching on because of the amount of debt that they can throw out. The bank buys it again, and then instead of the money that they want to change hands, the amount, the velocity of cash is not changing hands. And that's what you need in order to have inflation take place. Velocity of cash has to change hands. I do expect we're going to not only have it, but I think we're, you know, I think we have it in food in a huge way. The commodities in general, oil, we've had a huge break from, you know, last year to this year, which keeps the commodity index down. Let's go to Rick in Denver, Colorado. Hey, Rick, what's going on?
Hello, Tom. How are you?
I'm doing great, man. Yourself?
No complaints on this end.
Cool, man.
Hey, I'm looking for an entry point for LABD, Tom.
Okay, let's take a look at it. This is the direction 300% inverse correlation of the S&P Biotech Index. And if we take a look at this right now, it's trading out at $30.78. If I go over to the IBB, which is the NASDAQ Biotech Index, this is down 17 cents. You're at 278. It, you know, this is weak, okay, but I expect it's going to try to, you know, it's, I don't think it's ready yet to shot. I mean, it looks to me like it's going to take one more shot at this, 286. I don't think it's going to get over it, but I expect you're going to take some kind of a shot at that higher level from a few days ago. Because what it did today, you had really light volume, you rejected the lower price thus far, and it's like, okay, you want to go test this high once again, so...
Okay, that's what I was thinking. It didn't look like it was going to make it back up to 300, but I was looking for a little verification.
Yeah, no, I don't think it's going to make it to 300, you know, because when you do pick apart some of these equities, like Gilead, G-I-L-D, that's 7% of it. That wants lower price. R-E-G-N, I believe that's down today. Let's see. Yeah, well, that's not bad. It's down $6. No big deal. Yesterday, and this was the heads up, folks. Yesterday, a Biogen got smoked. It was down $35 yesterday. Big volume. AMGN, if we look at Amgen, Amgen's just rolling over slowly. You know, I think, you know, listen, we're almost there. I just give it a few more days.
Okay, thanks, Tom. I appreciate
okay.
it.
Okay, have a great one. Have a safe one. You stay right there, folks. We'll come right back. Dow Industrials right now are up 59. We get the NASDAQ up 13. S&Ps are up 7.5. We're going to be right back.
Tom O'Brien's weekly gold letter, The Gold Report, gives complete and concise coverage of the entire gold market. Inside, you'll get Tom's commentary on gold, the dollar, the rand, the bond, the XAU, the HUI, and detailed coverage of nearly 25 mining stocks. He'll give you the entry price, price target, and stop price of each stock trade. The Gold Report is a long-term newsletter where the focus is on building real wealth through the management of a successful portfolio of gold stocks. With a lifetime of knowledge and almost 12 years of writing his informative weekly newsletter, The Gold Report, Tom O'Brien can provide you with the important market information to help you make better trades in the gold market. Don't let the next bull run in gold pass you by. To get a month-long free trial to The Gold Report, an $85 value, visit the front page of TFNN.com today.
Today, it's hard to tell if the economy is coming or going. Regardless, I want my money going in the direction I choose. If that's your stance as well, then you want to know how EverBank can help keep your money thriving just the way you want. Is growing your money a priority? EverBank is committed to a yield pledge promise to pay high yields on your checking, money market, and CD balances. Looking to diversify? EverBank ingeniously developed accessible ways to spread your money around the world into foreign currencies and even non-FDIC insured metals. And when it comes to your wealth, they bring a highly experienced and global perspective to help you manage it. EverBank's financial philosophy flies in the face of the status quo. They believe your money's performance should not be determined by today's economic circumstances, but by the drive to rise above them and create opportunities that favor your objectives. If that excites you, like it does me, call 1-855-750-4051 to find out what they can do for you. That's 1-855-750-4051. Call them today. EverBank is a member FDIC and Equal Housing Lender.
Hi, I'm Steve Rhodes, host of The Trader's Edge, heard daily at TFNN.com and author of Mastering Probability, a daily investment and trading newsletter service that I send out each morning by 8 a.m. My morning newsletter service covers exactly what the markets have been doing since last night's close, providing you with an edge on your trading day ahead. You get actionable trading ideas, including the exact entry, stop, and profit targets. Plus, I'll teach you the patterns and hidden market correlations that will make you a better trader. As a subscriber, you'll gain access to my 90-minute money management workshop, where I'll teach you the secrets that'll save your assets. The bottom line, I've got your back, including a 30-day money-back guarantee. See for yourself the type of analysis I provide each trading day by signing up for Mastering Probability today. With nothing to lose, this is an offer you should not pass on. Mastering Probability can be found under trading newsletters on the front page of TFNN.com.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Welcome back, folks. We have the Dow right now up 59, NASDAQ's up 13, S&Ps are up 7. Let's go to Richard in New Hampshire. Hey, Richard, what's going on?
Yeah, how you doing?
I'm doing great, man. Yourself?
I'm doing excellent.
Cool, man.
Okay. LNG, LF, I bought this at 46 cents and I sold today at 85. And the question is, did I make a mistake in selling too soon?
Nope, no way. It's a beautiful thing, brother. So let's take a look at it. It's LNG, LF.
Yes.
This equity, folks, is an Australian equity. trades in the U.S. So what they do, it's a liquefied natural gas limited, develops and operates small and medium scale liquefied natural gas projects in Australia. Now check this out. The company uses standard gas, which is natural gas already discovered, but has no identifiable markets for it. So what natural gas, folks, we have so much natural gas, it's unbelievable. The kicker is, you get it out of the ground, how do you store it, and where you're going to put it, and who's going to buy it? So this company's telling us flat out that, yeah, they have the gas, but they don't have a customer. And I suspect that what more than likely happens when Australia is huge, folks. So I can picture that more than likely this might be in the middle of nowhere, and great, you get a whole bunch of gas, and you know who's the end user and how you're going to get it there. Anyway, that being said, the low for the year is 35 cents. The high is 328. Richard made a nice score because the bottom line is that this equity was 37 cents 8 trading days ago. You know, today exploded. The last 4 days it actually exploded. It got up to a dollar today. It's trading at 84 cents. Yeah, man. I mean, you know, how did you pick up on this in the first place, Richard?
Well, I saw that they got a big contract someplace, and the volume picked up.
Okay.
And it's been in a long-term downtrend. So I took a...
Good for you, man.
I took a chance on it with some the gains I made from gold. So.
That's a beautiful thing. Well, listen, man, you did good. You know, because the bottom line is that they're claiming they're going to take in $2 million this year. Thus far, they're taking in $359,000 in the quarter. That's the highest amount of money that they've ever taken in. You know, and that's pretty intense when you are talking about a market cap of $422 million. It makes zero sense, man. So,
Should I buy on a pullback? Or
if you're going to buy on a pullback, I'd be waiting, and I'd be waiting in a huge way. I mean, you know, the pullback would be 48 cents. You're at 84. You know,
it has a lot of gaps in it. So.
Oh, listen, to me, I don't believe this stock is real, man. You have a $500 million market cap almost, right? And they take in $376,000. I mean, you know, it doesn't fly. I mean, but you know what you could do? Just to see whether it's real, find out where the natural gas is and find out how far in the boondocks it is. And, you know, that would give you an indication of do they have a shot to bring the natural gas from where it is to where they think they can sell it.
I've been having a good year. My portfolio is up 40% since January.
If you're in the gold market, that's a beautiful thing. I mean, because we know those gold stocks are up huge amounts of money, man. It was very quick.
Yeah, I bought a lot of the low price ones in January.
It's a beautiful thing, brother.
Yeah, yes, it is. I went to Smoky Bones the other day.
Oh, did ya?
Yeah,
that's
Nashua.
What Rich is talking about, folks, is that we actually did a show up there, and we had the station in Nashua. I remember when they just opened, we did a show. I love Smoky Bones, man. That's so cool. You got to love it, man. Well, listen, thank you so much for the call. We appreciate you growling and prowling with us out here.
Okay.
Thanks, Richard. Have a great one, man.
Yeah,
have a safe one. Let's go to John in Philly. Hey, John, what's going on?
Hey, Tommy. Thanks for taking the call.
So what's happening, brother?
Tommy, you just in the past 45 minutes did go through XAU and HUI. So thank you for that. I'm just looking at the price action in the past 2 hours on GDX, which mimics HUI.
Right.
Would you just kindly go through price and volume? Now, of course, today's high is higher than May 2nd. Now we're underneath it. So I'm looking at the volumes. Can you just share the parameters that you see as to what today's action and where we close would likely mean as you see it, looking out, say, the next 2 weeks?
Sure. So the GDX, folks, okay, is the Gold Miners Vectors ETF, okay? And inside this ETF, you have the larger gold miners, meaning just like the HUI. You get Barrick, Newmont, Gold Corp, Bonico Eagle, Newcrest, Franco-Nevada. So what you have out here with the GDX today is that you have a test of the high, you have a failure, and you have a failure with light volume. You know, we've done 59 million shares. The high that we're talking about is 26.17. You did 84 million. Now, that being said, guess what? If this thing's going to have a hard time breaking into on the downtrend of 25.42. And the reason being is that on the 18th of May, that was the high of the downtrend. That went, when it went from 25.42 to 23. And the up trend on last Wednesday, let's see, Wednesday, what day is today? Today Wednesday or Tuesday? What is it? Today's Wednesday.
Today's Wednesday.
Thank you. So last Friday, that 25.36, that's going to be hard to break on the way down. That's the way this looks. So what I expect you're going to see here is that you're going to build some cars in order to break over these levels. And now what I'm doing here is this, John and folks, okay? I'm also putting together, it doesn't look to me that the dollar index wants to stop here. You know, we're so close to the highs of the low. It's like, you know, you got to 93.41, you're at 93.60. It's like, you know what, man, this is going to go down and whack it. So if it goes down and hits it, what is that going to do? That's going to put more juice inside the GDX, okay? And then one of the main reasons I actually went through that bond exercise is that these bonds want higher price. These interest rates are going down, man. This is like over the top, but you get these bonds going topside again. Europe is going negative across many notes and bonds. That puts the dollar lower. That puts bonds higher. That puts commodities higher. So,
if I get you right there for your when we're looking, you have Friday the 3rd, big up move, big volume.
Yep.
And then it was back on the 18th, and that was the that was Fed minutes day.
Right.
Where you had big down but big volume. So I see that volume we're looking at. Would it be fair to say a decent trade idea would be if you can get it back close to 25-ish, that'd be it. With lighter volume, you take a shot on the long side looking for coming back up to 26.17, that sort of thing?
Intraday, yeah. I'm staying long. You know,
gotcha.
This is quite a run, you know.
Right.
There's going to be more. There's more bread made, you know, just staying right there, man. So.
Good.
But that's
Tommy,
intraday.
So
intraday, that's a decent deal. Cooking, brother. Stay right there, folks. We'll come right back. Dow Industrials right now up 57. You get the Nasdaq up 11. S&Ps are up 5.5. We're going to be right back.
TFNN is excited to offer a brand new piece of market scanning software unlike anything the industry has ever seen. John Logan and his team have spent years developing their market profile tools to finally be able to release the TAS Profile Scanner Plus. And right now, you can get a 2-week trial absolutely free just by visiting TFNN.com and providing us your name and email address. The TAS Profile Scanner Plus is the premier market profile-based scanner in the industry, powered by the acclaimed TAS proprietary algorithms. This feature-rich scanner is a standalone desktop software that instantly filters over 2,500 global financial markets such as stocks, ETFs, commodity futures, and Forex. Within 3 minutes of signing up, you can have the software downloaded and running on your computer with a complete roadmap of market indicators and inflection points to trade off using the TAS Profile Scanner Plus. Sign up today and try this amazing piece of software by visiting TFNN.com. Tiger Real Estate Opportunity Fund is currently offering 4-year first mortgages on many of the fully renovated properties that it has purchased. The first mortgages are third-party appraised with a maximum loan-to-value ratio of 70%, providing a secured investment that pays a fixed return of 5% annually, which works out to a monthly income of more than $416 per $100,000 investment with your principal intact and secured. These 4-year first mortgages are perfect for anyone looking for a secured investment that provides monthly income, much like a CD. For more information, email tigerfund@tfnn.com or click on the Tiger Real Estate Opportunity Fund banner along the right side of the tfnn.com homepage or call our office directly at 877-518-9190. There's a limited supply, so act now. The Path of Least Resistance is David White's daily trading newsletter, and if you're looking for active trading ideas, then now's a perfect time for a 30-day free trial to this powerful daily trading advisory service. David uses his years of trading experience to offer his subscribers his trading ideas each morning in his Path of Least Resistance newsletter. Using a combination of equity trades along with options, David keeps his subscribers up to date with all pertinent market information with intraday afternoon updates when warranted. Don't miss out on this great chance to get a 30-day free trial to David's daily newsletter, The Path of Least Resistance, with no obligation to pay anything. David has been delivering solid recommendations for his subscribers recently, and if you'd like to see the type of newsletter he delivers every morning, then visit the front page of TFNN, and you'll find The Path of Least Resistance under Trading Newsletters. For all the details and to start your 30-day free trial today, log on to TFNN.com now.
Tom, take your phone calls now. Toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Tom O'Brien.
Welcome back, folks. Right now, you get the Dow up 58. You get the NASDAQ up 11.5. S&Ps are up, let's see where we are. We get the S&Ps up 7.5. And if we go over and we take a look at the volume characteristics for the indices first, we're at 631 million. So that means we're going to come in at, let's see, we have 15 minutes. That's going to come in at 850 again. On the NASDAQ composite, what you get right now, we are at 1.4. That's going to come in at 1.7. If we go into the ETF structures, the SPY right now is 50 million. Bottom line, it looks like it's going to close over that high. So this baby wants to get up and hit that May high. The NDX 100, the 3Qs, that is doing, actually, this is doing 12 million. It should be, the Qs should be doing like 20, 21 million, folks. But what I expect we're going to see here is that all of these have to catch up with each other. But my bear suit, folks, I think I took the suit off the hanger. That's kind of where I'm standing right now. And we're at 110.36, 111.44 it wants to test. The kicker here, and there was a question actually in the den here earlier, and what the kicker was, the question was having to do with the dollar index going lower and market going higher. And that, yes, I believe that that's what is happening, number one. You know, this market does like a weak dollar. There's no two ways about it. That being said, I expect, and this is why we're pretty close right now, is that the dollar is almost down into that high volume swing low when it got crushed. You know, so the high volume swing low that we're talking about is from May 3rd. The high of that is 93.03, the low is 91.88. So when I look at the scenario, it's like, you know what, man, this thing can get into the high, reject it, do another bounce. As it does another bounce, that's when you get another small turnover, meaning you come down on the market, and we'll see what sectors at that particular point are weak. Because you definitely have a few of the signs out here that this thing wants to go south. Time-wise is the tough deal here, you know, because if we do have the dollar index continue to lower price and bonds continue higher, and as when I was just talking with John, and it looks to me like gold wants to go higher, that'll keep markets higher. That's the bottom line, you know. So, you know, lower rates is free money, and you know they'll push this thing higher because equities also, folks, it's not that equities are a hard asset, but what that is that, guess what? If there's free money, they're going to go in the equity market. So we'll see how this shakes out in the next week and a half. And I think one of the keys will be this whole commodity complex. If we go over and we take a look at the commodity complex today, it is phenomenal. The amount of juice and the percentage moves inside the commodity complex. Coffee was up 5.5% today. Silver is up 3.6. Soybeans 3. Sugar 2.8. Cattle 2.3. Wheat 2%. Gasoline 2%. Heating oil 1.7. Crude 1.6. Gold 1.3. Hogs 1.3. Corn 0.9%. Aluminum 0.7%. Cocoa 0.6%. Copper 0.4%. Cotton 0.1%. Orange juice down 0.2%. Nickel down 0.9%. And natural gas off 0.7%. If we go over and we take a look at Freeport MacMoRan, FCX, that's this is going to be the largest copper miner in the world. Freeport MacMoRan is trading up 36 cents. And bottom line is that this still looks like it wants to trade back into the $10.49 area. Not enough juice out here. And Freeport MacMoRan had an amazing run, too, by the way, okay? You know, the run that we're talking about, Freeport MacMoRan went from $3.70 January 13th up to $14.10. So I expect this consolidation will stay here for a bit. If we do pull it back, we are at, so it has big support at the 1049 area, but this looks like it's going to have to build cars for a longer period of time. And the there was a question about what is the low to shoot for in the 10-year yield. If you're asking that question in the context of refinancing your house or getting a mortgage, just get the mortgage. I wouldn't mess with it, folks. The reason being is that, the rates are low. And can they get lower? Yes, they can. There's no doubt about that. The way that the 10-year is set up right now, if this busts higher, it looks like the 10-year is going to go to 1.5. And that will be pretty amazing. The thing that has not translated compared to how the first time, let me show you something on the spike, because I remember this, and it probably has to do with that there are just more people inside the housing market now. If I pull the 30-year back, I want to show you something here. About 3.5 years ago, so when you take a look at the 30-year, right, the high in the 30-year right now is from, on a continuous contract, it's from February. It's 170.26. Well, if you go back 3 years when we were trading out there, like even at 153, and the 10-year TY, it's always hard to bring it up, the 10-year. My point is this, is that the 10-year about 3.5 years ago was slightly lower than this, but yet the 30-year rates were lower. You know, the 30-year rates at that particular point were running at 3.45. And right now they're about 3.65. That has to do with supply and demand, I expect. You know, but what you do have here is that this 10-year looks like it wants to break topside, and you were right next to it, man. I mean, you're talking about 7 ticks. And you blow away 7 ticks, that's going to be 2 points higher on a price, and that's going to bring that yield down. And what I expect you're going to see on this next run is that if, in fact, that's what happens, this thing's going to go further than 2 points up on the 10-year. The reason I'm saying that is because it just seems impossible that the rates can get lower, and the amount of positions that are laying there are probably quite extensive because we've been here for quite a while. The way that these commodity markets are running look to me that this is going to be one of these deals that inflation is out of the bag. Hey, we'll see what it shakes out. The ironic part about the bonds going higher is that the market is going higher simultaneously. So that's a change in venue, meaning most of the time bonds are going low and the market is going higher. Now you can make an argument that bonds can go higher, more cheap money can send more money into the marketplace. Wild. Yeah, and we won't tell Janet Yellen that yields are going down because, of course, the Fed still Well, they haven't been claiming lately that they, in fact, have you noticed that all the Fed and the Fed governors have disappeared? You know, now after the last time, they were out all over the place. Well, guess what? We haven't heard from one all week long. We had Janet Yellen, that was it. Everyone else is hiding. Woof, woof, woof. They're all crying, yelling woof, and no one's believing them anymore. You stay right there, folks. We're coming right back.
Larry Pesavento has just started his brand new service, Fibonacci 24/7, and he's already delivering content to his subscribers on a daily basis when the market's opened and even on weekends. Each Monday, you'll receive Larry's written report that provides detailed commentary and a summary on the charts and videos that Larry sends out. And throughout the week, when warranted, Larry will send out via charts or videos or both the key markets that he is watching during the day. This will be up-to-the-date, active trading information that will help you in your daily trading. In Larry's first week alone, he sent out 25 charts, 6 videos, and a full report to his subscribers in just 1 week. If you're a technical trader that uses patterns and retracements to trade, then Larry's service Fibonacci 24/7 is something that you must try. Right now, new subscribers can get a full 30-day money-back guarantee. With nothing to risk, sign up now to Larry Pesavento's Fibonacci 24/7 by visiting the front page of TFNN.com under Trading Newsletters. Since 1984, Basil Chapman has been using the Chapman Wave methodology to advise traders of his expert market opinion. While originally hand-drawing charts from the late 1970s into the 1980s, Basil noticed that prices under most circumstances virtually always had a certain number of legs to the upside before declining sharply. Later, Basil found that computer software, which included the standard market technical indicators, enhanced the degree of accuracy in calling price turns as well as market trend calls. Thus was born the Chapman Wave sequence. Using the Chapman Wave methodology along with other indicators, Basil Chapman advises his subscribers of his expert market opinion each market day with his opening call newsletter. Right now, you can get a 2-week free trial to the opening call, Basil's daily trading newsletter, by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Cancel at any time during that trial and pay absolutely nothing. Get your 2-week free trial to Basil's newsletter, the opening call, today by visiting TFNN.com. TFNN is excited about our new software charting program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts. In collaboration with Tom O'Brien and using his best-selling book, The Art of Timing the Trade, Your Ultimate Trading Mastery System, David White has programmed an outstanding piece of software that will complement any trader's methodology. Using this first-of-its-kind program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts allows you to scan thousands of stocks for Fibonacci formation setups, including Gartley's, ABC's, Butterflies, and much more. The Art of Timing the Trade Charts is designed to help you when scouring the markets for stocks just beginning to form the trading patterns that many investors spend days, weeks, or even months searching to find. And right now, we're offering licenses available at only $79 a month. We are so confident that you're going to love this new charting software that will even give you a 30-day unconditional money-back guarantee. Don't miss out on this incredible new piece of software. Get your copy of The Art of Timing the Trade Charts today by visiting TFNN.com.
This segment is brought to you by TFNN. Test drive all the newsletters for free at TFNN.com.
Welcome back, folks. Dow right now is up 57. You get the NASDAQ up 12. S&Ps are up 7.5. And as we go into, let's go take a look at the Dow Industrials, the strength versus the weakness inside the Dow today. So the strength is United Health. That's up 2.4%. Caterpillar is up about 1.7. Visa is up 1.2. And Pfizer is up 1.1. Taken away from it on the way down, you have Verizon's down 0.6. DuPont's down 0.6. Travelers is down 0.3. And Goldman Sachs is off 0.3. So mostly out there, you get the winners inside the Dow Industrials. Inside the NDX 100, what we have, CSX is the winner out there today. That's up 2%. You have Henry Schein is up 1.8%. Google is 1.6. Taken away from it, Ctrip is down 5.1%. Vodafone is down 3.7%. JD.com is down 3.3%, and Micron Tech is off 3%. Let's go over and take a look at, in the world of retailing, the king of retailing, Amazon. Amazon just refuses to back off. Amazon right now is trading at $727.27. And bottom line, it's hanging up there, man. It's hanging up there, and it just won't back off. Google, which is putting some juice inside the NDX 100 today, it's up $11 at $728. Now, the cool thing with Google is that Google wants lower price. You know, when Google came down in February, it was vicious. Google went from a price point of $789 on April 2nd. Five trading days later, it was at $663. Now, the volume is a monster on the way down. It's 6.17 million on the daily basis. Now, check this out. It's pretty cool. So it did a full counter trend bounce and goes from a price point of 663 February 8th. And by the 19th of April, it's all the way up to 769 again. Now, then what does it do? It blows apart again. It blows apart with 5.9 million shares. And that's what it's trying to do once again, folks, okay? That's the setup. And so what's cool about this is that I suspect next couple of days it wants to run to 739. That'll be all she wrote again. And what does that, what does that do? That's bringing into that huge supply line. Then you match that up with the context of where the market is. And I suspect what we're going to see, let's go to ExxonMobil just for a second, you know, because what you do have, you know, you get the ExxonMobil and you get the Chevron. That is still getting slightly higher. The XLE, even though it's getting weaker, it looks like it still wants to hit the 72 area. And right now we hit 70.26 today. And I suspect that is what's going to get the SPX into that high of May of 2015. You know, we've made it to 21.20 out here today. So now you're talking, you're only 14 points away from that high. You know, the whole thing's getting, it's getting really close. So that's one side. The other side, I'm sure there's questions out there, say, okay, do you just blow that number away? Well, when you do get up this high, I expect that it's gonna be a spike high. And what a spike high specifically does, the market will go up to it, stutter, stay, boom, blow right through it, and then would likely just give it up, you know, because the indices themselves have been rising now for a good amount on light volume. The real key, I think one of the keys that would change my view, that it would not only spike it but get higher, is going to have to do with this dollar. Because if this dollar does blow away the 91.88 area and goes to 88, where all the markets are going to go. Because that just means cash is worth nothing anymore. So, if it goes that fast, let's put it that way. You stay right there, folks. We're coming right back with some numbers for you. Dow right now is up 59. You got the NASDAQ up 11. S&Ps are up 7.5. We're going to be right back.
The following is a presentation of TFNN. The Tom O'Brien Show is produced every business day. Tom takes your phone calls toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Let's go to Seem in Dallas.
Hi, Tom. I love your show.
Thank you so
much.
I've
been listening to you since 2001 from my Seattle days when you were on a little station there.
I appreciate you growling and prowling with us out there, man. Thank you. Well, listen, thanks for bringing us from Seattle to Dallas, man. Appreciate it.
Yeah. I love all the hosts. I love your show. I'm addicted to it.
It's Hotel California. It's wicked, isn't it, man? Thanks.
All right, Tom. Nice to talk to you.
Have a great one. Have a safe one.
Now, Tom O'Brien.
Welcome, folks. This is Tom O'Brien of TFNN. We go 5 days a week. We go 10 hours a day. We go 24 hours a day on the internet at TFNN.com. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. Hope everyone's having a great day, safe day. Let's make it a great night, folks. Practice makes the master. Always do your best. By doing your best over and over, you can master the art of transformation. By doing your best, the habits of misusing your word, taking things personally, and making assumptions will become weaker and less frequent with time. Market-wise! guys, let's take a look at it out here. We have the Dow Industrials up 66, NASDAQ up 12, S&P's up 7.5, gold contract up $17.80, trading at $1,264 an ounce. Silver up 65 cents at $17.04 an ounce. Platinum up 11 bucks, 10.10 an ounce. Copper up a penny at $2.06 a pound. Light sweet crude up a buck, trading $51.36 a barrel. Bonds, 10-year note flat, 130.30. 30-year bond up 15 ticks, 166.30. The notes and the bonds, folks, are building cars to get up and over their highs. Higher bond prices, higher note prices equal lower interest rates. King dollar. King dollar's getting toasted and roasted. King dollar's down 237 ticks, 93.59. King dollar is going after its swing low from a few weeks ago of 91.88. Now, if we break 91.88, you're going to go to 88 on the dollar index. And the way the commodities are trading out here, folks, it looks like that the King dollar does want to trade down into those much lower levels. Euro. The euro is trading at $1.13. That's up 37 ticks. And the yen is at 107, and that's down 29 ticks. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. Give us a call, folks. Want to know what's going on in your world. In the world of the S&Ps, let's take a look at them. What do you have? We start with the SPY. SPY right now closed out the day at $212.37. The high that it's shooting for is the May high of 2015, and that's 213.78. The low of that high is $212.16. We're already into it. That brings the probability much higher. You're going to go into it. If we go to the cash, and the cash would be the best one to look at, folks. The cash is at 21.18, and we right now are only, let's see, you're talking about 21.34. So bottom line is that you're 22 points away from the high right now, and I expect that high is going to get tested, and we'll see whether we're going to get that spike high and get up and over it, either hold it or not hold it. And the NQs, the three Qs. What do we have with the three Qs? Three Qs right now up 19 cents at $110.37. This wants to run to the April highs, which is $111.44. You know, the Qs are weak. They're right now, they're laying down, weakness across the board. The highs inside the NDX 100, that would be the December 2015 highs is at 115.75. I don't see the Qs making it up there. These indices are all doing a little bit differently, but the Qs have shown that they're weak. Russell 2000. Now, the Russell 2000 doesn't look like it's going to make it up there either. Well, at this point, the Russell 2000, I expect, will make it up at some point. The reason being is that because the commodities are rocking and rolling. Right now, the small cap Russell 2000 is at 1189, and what is game is 1205. 1205 is the high of December of 2015. Oil contract. What do we have with oil? Bottom line, folks, what I expect you're going to see, it's going to be the oil and gas equities that are going to bring the S&P up to the high. Why? Well, guess what? Oil contract out here today is trading at 51.36, and you're talking about monster volume. You're talking about over the swing high with juice. We've done 593,000 contracts out here. That's setting up about a 53 to 54 barrel of oil. You get a 53 or 54 barrel of oil. If we go over to the XLE for a second, what you're going to see is that the XLE right now is at 69.39. The XLE looks like it wants to run up to the swing high of November of 2015, which is 71.93. Gold contract, what do we have with gold? Bottom line, gold, silver, want higher price. Silver was actually pretty incredible out here today. Gold, nice run, $17.60. We did volume 167,000 contracts. That sets up the run to 1308. We'll see whether we take 1308 out. Silver was an incredible run. Wide price spread, huge volume. We're at $17. What you do have is that silver, you talk about volatility, it has it. We've done 70,000 contracts out here today. That's a monster, folks. It's huge. The high And silver is $18.06. It's going to go for that high. The silver equities, you know, if you get the gold report, I was mentioning the silver equities have been, were the strongest. That's what's leading the silver market in an incredible way. The 10-year notes, what we have with the notes is that they are laying right at their highs. Bottom line, we'll see what pushes them over the highs. Right now, you're at 130.30. The 10-year notes only need another 7 ticks to break highs. Right now, closing high, we're 7 ticks away from a closing high. The closing high in this contract is 131.07. The 10-year yield right now is at 1.700. So more than likely, we're going to see that 10-year yield broken probably tomorrow. And what is it all about? Good old King Dollar, folks. King Dollar came down today, had juice behind the move on the way down. So you got big sellers in King Dollar. We've done 35,000 contracts. And not that that's a huge amount, but it's another expansion of volume on the way down. We're only going into the lows had 31,000. And that's after the King Dollar trying to make a high last week. And that was with 8,000 contracts and 17,000. You can see the correlation. It's a whopped correlation, meaning many more sellers than buyers. And what does that set up on a fundamental basis? What that sets up as a fiat currency is that central banks across the world are what? They're pushing huge amounts of paper out, bringing rates down, getting into negative rates in Europe. And what does that do? That forces the supply and demand issue, not the Fed. The Fed continues to say they want higher rates. Well, guess what? The market's saying you can wish anything and everything you want, Chairman or Chairwoman Yellen and the rest of the Fed governors. The market is dictating right now, and the market is dictating lower rates, lower yield. Lower rates, lower yield equal what? Lower dollar. Why? Because more paper is out in the marketplace. It's Tom O'Brien. This is TFNN. You stay right there, folks. We'll be coming right back. Dow Industrials up 66. NASDAQ up 12. S&P's up 7.5. We're going to be right back.
If you're an active trader looking for that extra edge when it comes to trading and investments, then now is a great time to get a 2-week free trial to Tom O'Brien's daily market letter, Market Insights. Tom O'Brien's daily newsletter, Market Insights, comes out every market day at around 9:30 a.m. and provides Tom's daily commentary on the broad market, including the Dow, NASDAQ, and S&P, plus specific trade recommendations. There's even an update published most afternoons to keep you informed about the day's market activity. He'll give you the entry price, price target, and stop price of each stock and option trade. With Market Insights, there's nothing left to guessing. For all the details and to get your 2-week free trial to Market Insights started today, visit TFNN.com.
Has the current market volatility continued to stop you out of trades when the market spikes against you? Now is the perfect time to open up an account with Nadex. Nadex, the North American Derivatives Exchange, is a brand new, completely regulated Chicago-based exchange, and unlike most other exchanges, Nadex allows you to trade directly through them with direct market access when using their completely free trading platform, which also features real-time charts and full customization capability. One of the advantages of trading with Nadex in volatile markets is that your risk is always capped and you have the ability of keeping your trades open even when the market spikes against you. Nadex is completely brand new with a line of unique trading products that are unavailable anywhere else. See how it works at Nadex.com. That's Nadex.com. Or click on the Nadex banner on the front page of TFNN.com. Futures and options trading involves risk and may not be appropriate for all investors. Are China A shares hot or not? If you trade China A-shares, now may be time to take a closer look. Trade CHAU or CHAD, Direction's daily CSI 300 China A-share bull and bear ETFs. China A-shares in either direction. Visit directioninvestments.com today.
An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Tom, take your phone calls. Now. Toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Welcome back, folks. We had the Dow finish up 66, NASDAQ is up 12, S&Ps are up 8. And if we take a look at some of the Dow stocks out here, this is what you have. You have Big Mac was up 21 cents. You had ExxonMobil up 8 cents. We had, Procter & Gamble was up 33. Big Blue, it was up 67. We had Honeywell up 72. And if we do go over and we go into this oil contract, what's increasing, you know, so oil, CLN6, what you have since the close of the pit, folks, and I haven't been able to find any news on it, but oil is moving higher, and I mean moving higher in a big way. Oil, when we were just starting the show, was at $51.13. Right now, we're running up at $51.47. And let me just see something else. Let me pull this up here for a second. This is quite a run for, there's no doubt the futures open back up again. Yeah, we're at 51. This thing's going to upside, 51.53. And it has the volume behind the move, So what I expect you're going to see here is that we're right next to the highs in the S&P. Let's go over to the Dow for a second, see if the Dow is going to hit the highs also. So right now we're at 18,005 in the Dow. And the high of the Dow is 18,351. The Dow's got quite a way to go. So the Dow first has to launch into this 18,137. And something that I expect what we're going to see here is this, is that the S&P itself, we're right next to it. That wants to hit it. The Dow doesn't necessarily have to get to the highs. The NASDAQ composite, let's go to the composite versus the NDX. So the composite right now is laying out at 49.74. And no, the composite's not going to hit it either. The high of the composite is 52.31. The composite looks to me like, yeah, you can get into this 5,000 area, which is, that's 25 points away from where we are. But as we get into that 5,000 area, it's going to be tough to, basically eat into that supply line, because that supply line is vicious from August of last year. That's what is giving this thing quite a hard time. And inside the context of the NDX as well as the composite is that you have those biotechs that have already signaled that they want lower price. If we go over to the IBB, you got to remember something, that the IBB inside the composite is a pretty good weighting structure. And inside the IBB, it was Biogen that fell apart, about a year and a half ago. Well, that fell apart again yesterday. The highest weighting structures go like this. You have Amgen is 8% of it, of the IBB, that is. Biogen is 7.9, Celgene is 7.6, Regeneron is 7.2, Gilead is 7, Vertex is 4, Alexa Pharmaceuticals 3.9, Mylan is 3.6, Illumina is 3.5, and Insight is 2.9. I believe Illumina has already fallen apart too. Let me just pull this up for a second. Yeah, it has. So Illumina in the last 6 months has just gone from 196 to 145, has a high volume, low swing low of 132. So bottom line is that the stretch is out here. There's no two ways about it. Decent stretch on the way up. But I expect, this market is just about ready to make a turn. Let's go over to Restoration Hardware. Restoration Hardware, closed at $36.07. That is trading at $31.69. So that's getting toasted. Oh, man. And, you know, they've just opened these huge stores. And evidently, those huge stores and the rents they're going to pay just don't work, because Restoration Hardware has just gone from $106. Oh, man, this is intense. $106 in November of 2015. And right now, you're trading, looks like it's going to do another ABC down. Let me see this. So $31.58, it is. It's going to go after another B point of an ABC down. This will be pretty intense, because the A point on this is $46.87. That was generated the 27th of April. What is that number again? 46.87. Wow. 17 points. 30.88. 17 points gets you a $20 stock. Yeah. Pretty intense. So let's see what Restoration Hardware is saying. So here we go. They lost 5 cents. The revenue estimate, let me see here. $455 million is what they took in. And it's actually saying first quarter loss is 33 cents. And then they adjusted it to 5 cents. Bottom line is that 33 cents. This is pretty intense, man. And it's cutting its yearly forecast. Yeah, so trouble in paradise in a big way. And I haven't been to the new store in Tampa. There's three, I guess, superstores, and they just opened one in Tampa. It's supposed to be incredible. But the bottom line is that it looks like it may be incredible, but it just cost them way too much money. So what you have here is that if we go back to 2012, the low was $24. The high was $38. This may have run from 2012 of that $38 up into the $106, and now it's going to basically run right down into these lows, and we'll see whether it takes now. But the way that this is trading right now is that there's another ABC structure on the way down to $20. What you can also get out of this, let me see if this is the third or the second gap. This is only the second gap down. This is, you know, this had gap down. It looks like the last time they come out with numbers, let's see, March, April, May, it would have been. On February 24th, it was trading at $52. On February 25th, it was at $37. And that's what we're going to see out here tomorrow. More than likely, what you're going to see, it's probably going to gap right below the lows. And this is trouble in paradise for another retailer. You know, the retailers themselves, folks, bottom line, are having tough times all over the place. And large retailers seem to be having even tougher times. Let's go over to the XAU and the HUI. The XAU out here today, Philadelphia Gold and Silver Index, that closed at $91.61. It traded to a high of $93.63. So the XAU did not make its high out here today. Where when we go to the HUI, I believe it did. And we won't get this volume until tomorrow. But it looks to me that there'd be a little less volume, so we need a little more volume in order to break over these highs in the XAU. If we go to the Gold Bugs Index, what you're going to see there with the Gold Bugs Index is that we are up $7.39. We traded to $237.09, and that did take it over the highs of $236.23. And it looks to me like we're not going to have that volume there either. So that's going to have to build some more cars to get up and over that area. And where you can get it from, by the way, folks, is the GDX. Oh, but look at this. Oh, man, this is going to be wild. Oh, you know what? Good old John from Philly. Guess what, folks? Someone came in the GDX and bought in a big way. And so now what you have, when John from Philly called, which was not that long ago in the last hour, we didn't have the volume. Someone came in and bought big. And so now you have a test of a high with volume. You gotta love it. Stay right there, folks. We'll come right back.
Yeah.
Today, it's hard to tell if the economy is coming or going. Regardless, I want my money going in the direction I choose. If that's your stance as well, then you want to know how EverBank can help keep your money thriving just the way you want. Is growing your money a priority? EverBank is committed to a yield pledge promise to pay high yields on your checking, money market, and CD balances. Looking to diversify? EverBank ingeniously developed accessible ways to spread your money around the world into foreign currencies and even non-FDIC insured metals. And when it comes to your wealth, they bring a highly experienced and global perspective to help you manage it. EverBank's financial philosophy flies in the face of the status quo. They believe your money's performance should not be determined by today's economic circumstances, but by the drive to rise above them and create opportunities that favor your objectives. If that excites you, like it does me, call 1-855-750-4051 to find out what they can do for you. That's 1-855-750-4051. Call them today. EverBank is a member FDIC and Equal Housing Lender.
Tom O'Brien's weekly gold letter, The Gold Report, gives complete and concise coverage of the entire gold market. Inside, you'll get Tom's commentary on gold, the dollar, the rand, the bond, the XAU, the HUI, and detailed coverage of nearly 25 mining stocks. He'll give you the entry price, price target, and stop price of each stock trade. The Gold Report is a long-term newsletter where the focus is on building real wealth through the management of a successful portfolio of gold stocks. With a lifetime of knowledge and almost 12 years of writing his informative weekly newsletter, The Gold Report, Tom O'Brien can provide you with the important market information to help you make better trades in the gold market. Don't let the next bull run in gold pass you by. To get a month-long free trial to The Gold Report, an $85 value, visit the front page of TFNN.com today.
It's 2016, and TFNN has a brand new programming lineup to kick things off. Starting January 4th, Swim Lessons by Thinkorswim and TD Ameritrade will be airing 5 days a week at noon Eastern Time. Join hosts Scott Connor, Kevin Hinks, and Cindy Faber as they host their daily options program live at noon 5 days a week with no commercials for the entire hour. Nico DeHaan and Paige Clark will be moving their program, Living a Primal Lifestyle, to twice a week, Tuesdays and Thursdays from 7 a.m. until 8 a.m. Eastern Time. Wake up with Nico and Paige and start your day off right. The Bull Bear Binary Option Hour by Nadex will now be live Mondays and Fridays at 10 a.m. Start and end the week with the three hosts, Tom O'Brien, Tommy O'Brien, and Daryl Martin, as they break down the world of trading binary options and spreads. For all the details on the new 2016 programming lineup, visit the front page of TFNN.com. TFNN, educating investors.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Welcome back, folks. 877-927-6648. Give us a call, folks. Want to know what's going on in your world. Now, let's go to the world of GDX. So watch this, folks, okay? When we had bisected and dissected this in the last hour, and it wasn't, I don't have the exact time, actually, last semester. No, I do have the time. So it was at 3:30. So at 3:30, the GDX had already got over its highs. It didn't have the volume. You know, and I had said to John, I says, well, you know, I think it's going to have a hard time breaking under the 25.36 because that's where we had strength last Friday, and that's where we had a downdraft on the 18th. Now, that being said, this is what we have now. So the high of the GDX was on the 2nd of May. The 2nd of May, $26.17, you had 84 million shares traded. Today, our high is $26.50. So you get over the high, and guess what? We had 97 million shares traded. And this is what you got. Now, watch this. I'm going to show you these trades, because what we got here is that on the close, you traded 15.9 million shares. Now, watch how this works. This is where this gets wild, folks, in the context of an ETF and an ETF that when you break it down, and we break the weighting structure down, what you're going to see is this. You get Barrick Gold is 9%, Newmont 7.9%, Goldcorp 6.4%, Agnico Eagle's 5.5%, New Crest Mining, you wouldn't know that one, wouldn't like it. That's an Australian stock, trades here, but that's 5.2. Franco Nevada's 5.2. Silver Wheaton's 4.3. Ken Ross is 4.2. And you have Anglo Ashanti, 4.1. And Rango Resources, 3.9. Now, what is so cool inside the ETF structures is that, now watch, I'm going to go over and I'm going to go to Barrick Gold, because we had also brought up ABX. And watch this now. When we bring up Barrick Gold, what you're going to see is at the close, you had 19 million shares all day. At the close, you had 223,000 shares come in, and right before the close, another 200,000. After the close, 177,000. So in the matter of, let's see, that's a matter of 30 minutes, you had almost 600,000 shares traded. Well, what happens, folks, is this, is that the ETF has to, so go back to GDX for a second, GDX. What happens is that the net asset value of the GDX has to match up with the weighting structures. So what you had out here is that the amount of volume that got pushed into the GDX, guess what's going to happen, folks? What's going to happen, and this is where the chicken and egg come in. As the GDX goes up, what do you think happens? They have to buy more of the equities that are inside the GDX. As they buy more of the equities, of course, inside the GDX, what ends up happening? Well, those equities go higher, so once again, it has to get bought again. It's going to be wild watching this thing shake out tomorrow, man, because that is a big number coming into the close, you know. And that number, you know, I suspect is going to, is going to basically push these equities into higher price. And of course, it's going to have once again to do with good old King Dollar. Let's go over to a couple of the silver equities. If we look at Hecla Mining up here today, up 24 cents, trading $4.64. We hit $4.74, which was 1 penny over the high. And guess what? We did it with volume. We did 11.4 million shares for today. We did 11.6 at the high. But that's cool, meaning that, yeah, you can build a little more cars. I expect you're going to see higher price. Pan American Silver, PAAS. Pan American Silver going into a downdraft that was pretty severe. That downdraft was on the 18th of May. We had gone from $16.12 to $14.56. You had done 5.7 million. Today, not bad. We did 3.7. So it's eating that supply line at that particular point. Great Panther. These are all silvers we're going to pull up first. Great Panther up 6 cents today. You're at 169. You're coming into also a severe downdraft that was out here on the 3rd of May. That was 6.1 million. We did 1.8. So Great Panther's going to have to build some more cars to get up and into this 180 area. First Majestic, AG. Bottom line, AG takes out its high, and let's see what we had here. Okay, so First Majestic is up 81 cents, 12.40, and now it didn't do it with volume, but it's above it. We did 5.9 million. You're dealing with 9.9 million. And on the weekly basis, it's also going to need more volume. So 12.23 versus the aspect of with that's 37 million, and thus far we've done 14 million. One of the Tigers making a comment in the den, I don't believe that volume with no price movement after hours. That's not what I'm talking about. So what you want to do is you want to wrap your head. I can understand that context. I mean, after hours, you get price movement. The context that I'm talking about is this. That's how ETF structures buy and sell, by the way, okay? That's definitely how if you look at the IWM, if you want to see how small caps go in the Russell 2000, it's just a total mind blower what they can put in sometimes at the end of the day. They have to put it in order to basically have the net asset value. The correlation in between the net asset value and the weighting of the indices are crucial to wrap your head around. The reason being is that it is the chicken and the egg. And when you're in an uptrend, it's awesome because you know that they have to buy. It's just a math flat out. This goes up, that has to go up. No, there's nothing in this. That's not even a trade. That's how it moves. On the way down, the exact same thing happens. So bottom line, and that correlation, what you're going to see is the bottom line is that there's more buying pressure coming in the marketplace. That's how that's set up. We go over and we take a look at the XLF, the financials. What we have with the financials out here, financials were flat out here today. You're up 2 pennies. And financials right now are at 23.62, and it looks like these banks are going to have a tough time making any bread. The banking structure itself, folks, is coming right into one monster supply line, and it doesn't look to me like this baby's going to make it. In fact, the way that the banking structure is set up right now, it looks like the banks may be the first ones to turn. Now, that would be really unusual if that's the case. The reason being is that the banking structure, the XLF, on a downtrend normally is one of the last ones to turn versus the first ones. You know, in this particular case, you know, you can definitely make the case, which I am making, is that lower interest rates put the banks in a tough position. This is Tom O'Brien, this is TFNN. You stay right there, folks, we'll be coming right back. Dow Industrials closed up 66, NASDAQ up 12.5. S&P's up 7.5. We're going to be right back.
TFNN is excited to offer a brand new piece of market scanning software unlike anything the industry has ever seen. John Logan and his team have spent years developing their market profile tools to finally be able to release the TAS Profile Scanner Plus. And right now, you can get a 2-week trial absolutely free just by visiting TFNN.com and providing us your name and email address. The TAS Profile Scanner Plus is the premier market profile-based scanner in the industry, powered by the acclaimed TAS proprietary algorithms. This feature-rich scanner is a standalone desktop software that instantly filters over 2,500 global financial markets such as stocks, ETFs, commodity futures, and Forex. Within 3 minutes of signing up, you can have the software downloaded and running on your computer with a complete roadmap of market indicators and inflection points to trade off using the TAS Profile Scanner Plus. Sign up today and try this amazing piece of software by visiting TFNN.com.
Since 1984, Basil Chapman has been using the Chapman Wave methodology to advise traders of his expert market opinion. While originally hand-drawing charts from the late 1970s into the 1980s, Basil noticed that prices under most circumstances virtually always had a certain number of legs to the upside before declining sharply. Later, Basil found that computer software, which included the standard market technical indicators, enhanced the degree of accuracy in calling price turns as well as market trend calls. Thus was born the Chapman Wave sequence. Using the Chapman Wave methodology along with other indicators, Basil Chapman advises his subscribers of his expert market opinion each market day with his opening call newsletter. Right now, you can get a 2-week free trial to the opening call, Basil's daily trading newsletter, by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Cancel at any time during that trial and pay absolutely nothing. Get your 2-week free trial to Basil's newsletter, The Opening Call, today by visiting TFNN.com.
Hi, I'm Steve Rhodes, host of The Trader's Edge, heard daily at TFNN.com and author of Mastering Probability, a daily investment and trading newsletter service that I send out each morning by 8 a.m. My morning newsletter service covers exactly what the markets have been doing since last night's close, providing you with an edge on your trading day ahead. You get actionable trading ideas, including the exact entry, stop, and profit targets. Plus, I'll teach you the patterns and hidden market correlations that will make you a better trader. As a subscriber, you'll gain access to my 90-minute money management workshop, where I'll teach you the secrets that'll save your assets. The bottom line, I've got your back, including a 30-day money-back guarantee. See for yourself the type of analysis I provide each trading day by signing up for Mastering Probability today. With nothing to lose, this is an offer you should not pass on. Mastering Probability can be found under trading newsletters on the front page of TFNN.com.
Tom.
Take your phone calls.
Now. Toll free at 1-877-927-6648.
Internationally
at 727-445-1044.
Tom O'Brien.
Welcome back, folks. The Dow finished up 66. You get the NASDAQ up 12. S&P's up 7.5. And what's going to get intriguing out here is that I haven't been able to see what is moving that oil market, but there's the oil numbers came out this morning. You know, bottom line, that you know they were what the market was expecting. That being said, this oil market has taken out these highs right now, and this buying just keeps coming in. You know, we're at 600. And 2,000 contracts right now. It's just blown away the swing point with 480,000. You know, so when we take a look at it, you get an A point of $43. Yeah, I get the right contract, $43.65. The B point is $50.21. 43, yes, yeah, so approximately, let's say $6.50. And that'll bring you up to $54. That's how this thing is running, man. Right now we're at 51.54. And what you do have is that, you know, we built the sideways movement, the B to C. And you got to remember something, that an ABC structure, the A to B point is a straight line move. B to C is a sideways move, goes all over the place, drives everyone crazy. C to D is a straight line move. So this very well may be that straight line move. And what's going to be cool here, if that's what it is, then the XLE will stay higher. You know, XLE, you know, the last couple days, in 4 days, we just went from $66 to 70. It has that swing point at 72. That swing point at 72 would line up that the S&P itself would get up to the highs of 2015. And then that correlation, I suspect, is that that's all she's going to write at this particular point. And we'll go back to the good old bond market. So if we go over to the bonds just for a second, the TLT right now, the TLT is a 20-year bond plus fund. That's the ETF structure. The highs in this structure are $135.25. The lows of the high of $133.01. And what you want to wrap your head around, now this is where this gets kind of cool with this, is that the expense ratio is 15/100. So that's what the expense ratio is. So when you take that, and I put this back, what you're going to see is that the, oh no, that's not the high though. So there's the high. Okay, so the high is 138. The high was generated January of 2015. Let me make sure that's the high too. Yeah, that's the high. So that was generated, whoops, one second. January of 2015, and what it looks like is, number one, we're going to get up to that level, and number two, we'll find out whether it's going to blow that level away. But what you have, my point is this. We're actually right into those highs right now, because when you do take the expense ratio away from the TLT right now would be somewhere up until, let's see, say 1.5. Every year, is that a yearly? One second, let me look at this for a second. Okay, so since inception, it's every year you're running at, so every 5 years you're at, every 10 years you're basically at a point and a half, which is percentage wise that's a big number. There's so bottom line is, this is going to make that run for the highs, and the rate structure across the world, folks, okay, continues lower. You know, right now, what you have is that a 10-year rate, and this broke records yesterday, and in fact, look at this. Is it down? It broke records. The 10-year bond in Germany is trading at 0.05%. 0.05. That's just over the top. If we go into the five-year rates, what you're going to see is that the negative aspect in Europe is pretty incredible. You know, so that says that our rates are going to continue down. You know, I mean, it seems to be a cut and dry deal. If you go over and we take a look at the commodity markets out here today, you talk about commodities running. There was only three commodities that trade, well, out of the 20 commodities that trade in a liquid basis, meaning trade quite a bit, only three of them were in the negative. Orange juice was down 2%, nickel was down 9/10, and natural gas was off 6/10. Tomorrow you get the natural gas numbers coming out. The big mover out here today was coffee and silver. Silver was up almost 4%. Well, we go take a look at some of the higher volume stocks in this marketplace. This is what we had out here. You had, steel. Let's go to the steel market, because U.S. Steel, AKS, these things ran, and they had some juice behind them. So U.S. Steel was up $1.77, $17.70. Let me pull this back and see what we have happening. This has been in a vicious downdraft. Okay, so you're above the 1660 level, which was the lows of 09. You're pushing with volume. This got some action, man. You're at $17. This is something we want to wrap our head around on retracements here. Because this got some action. AKS, you talk about a little rocket ship out here today. This is pretty intense. So you get a $5 stock. It was actually a $4.50 stock that went up 77 cents. Gets into a swing point of 524 and blows it away. You know, we had 30 million shares versus 10 million. SLX, let's see what we got with SLX. SLX, this is the Vanek Victor Steel ETF. Oh, that's pretty cool, Duffy. Thanks, man. So inside of this, I see, okay. So inside of this, this is a steel ETF, but you also have Vale, which is the iron ore producer. So this is also not only the steel stocks, but the producers of the iron ore. And this baby also went up $1.11. And if we pull this back, yeah, you get a nice consolidation taking place here. If we go over to Valley, V-A-L-E, yeah, this caught a bid too. There's going to be Valley's going to need a little more volume. We own Valley right now. It's going to need a little more volume, but this does want to get up into this swing high of $6.26. That's the way it seems to be sitting right now. We go take a look at a few of these gold stocks. Franco Nevada, that's up 93 cents today. We did 700,000 and 760,000 contracts. Now, this is pretty cool because it's just laying right under its high. If we go take a look at Royal Gold, and these ones here give you a good indication. Franco Nevada, Royal Gold, they give you a decent, look at Royal Gold got strong again. This is pretty cool. So Royal Gold, folks, you know, took out its high and took it out with volume. We get another ABC up. We get action, man. Action! This is Tom O'Brien. This is TFNN. You stay right there, folks. We're coming right back. Dow Industrials closed up 66, NASDAQ up 12, S&P's up 7.5, gold up $18, silver up 66 cents, platinum up $11, King Dollar down 232. We're going to be right back.
Larry Pesavento has just started his brand new service, Fibonacci 24/7, and he's already delivering content to his subscribers on a daily basis when the market's opened and even on weekends. Each Monday, you'll receive Larry's written report that provides detailed commentary and a summary on the charts and videos that Larry sends out. And throughout the week, when warranted, Larry will send out via charts or videos or both the key markets that he is watching during the day. This will be up-to-the-date active trading information that will
will help you in your daily trading. In Larry's first week alone, he sent out 25 charts, 6 videos, and a full report to his subscribers in just 1 week. If you're a technical trader that uses patterns and retracements to trade, then Larry's service Fibonacci 24/7 is something that you must try. Right now, new subscribers can get a full 30-day money-back guarantee. With nothing to risk, sign up now to Larry Pesavento's Fibonacci 24/7 by visiting the front page of TFNN.com under Trading Newsletters. David White's newsletter, The Technology Insider, is focused like a laser on finding the next big things in technology. If you had invested only $10,000 in Microsoft in 1986, you'd have been a millionaire by 2000. Disruptive technology like Microsoft's is the key to these massive long-term profits, and The Tech Insider is the vehicle from TFNN to capitalize on these opportunities. This is the go-to newsletter that identifies, monitors, and profits on mostly little-known cutting-edge companies with great long-term prospects. David's experience is as an inventor of Emmy-winning animation products for TV and Hollywood that propelled a company public. Match that with 14 years as a full-time trader, and he's uniquely qualified to guide you through the light-speed world of ever-evolving high-tech. If you're ready to ride the next big technology bull market for less than $40 per month, log on to TFNN.com and get your 2-week free trial to the Technology Insider. Get in on the ground floor of the next big thing today. Tiger Real Estate Opportunity Fund is currently offering 4-year first mortgages on many of the fully renovated properties that it has purchased. The first mortgages are third-party appraised with a maximum loan-to-value ratio of 70%, providing a secured investment that pays a fixed return of 5% annually, which works out to a monthly income of more than $416 per $100,000 investment with your principal intact and secured. These 4-year first mortgages are perfect for anyone looking for a secured investment that provides monthly income, much like a CD. For more information, email tigerfund@tfnn.com or click on the Tiger Real Estate Opportunity Fund banner along the right side of the tfnn.com homepage, or call our office directly at 877-518-9190. There's a limited supply, so act now.
This segment is brought to you by TFNN. Test drive all the newsletters for free at tfnn.com.
Welcome back, folks. And folks, don't forget, at TFNN, every Monday, Wednesday, Friday, we start live programming at 8 o'clock in the morning. We go to 5 in the afternoon. On Tuesday and Thursday, we start at 7 o'clock in the morning. We go to 6 in the afternoon. All of that programming, you can get right on your cell phone. You go to TFNN.com, hit Tiger TV. You're going to get great HD quality video as well as audio. My man, Mr. John Logan, kicks us off every trading day, 8 o'clock in the morning. Then we go on to, that's 8 to 9. Larry Pesavento, Steve, 8 to 9 to 10. My son Tom and me, 10 to 11. Basil Chapman, 11 to 12. At 12, folks, if you trade options, we have TD Ameritrade, Thinkorswim, their swim lessons. That's Kevin Hinks. Scott and Cindy, an amazing show. Steve Rhodes, 1 to 2. Dave White, 2 to 3. I'm back, 3 to 5. And, of course, Andy Heck, 5 to 6 on Tuesdays and Thursdays. So if you do enjoy the programming, please tell 3 people. We do appreciate you out there growling and prowling with us and continuing to make us grow, and we do appreciate it. And I want to thank each and every one of you, because it's quite a ride. There's no two ways about that. And we talk about quite a ride. The market is on quite a ride right now. The real kicker is going to be, where does the metals go, where does oil go, and where does the king dollar go? The amazing part about king dollar is that, you know, if we just look back even a couple of months, it seemed that, you know, bottom line, our Fed was saying, hey, we got to go up, we got to go up, we got to go up. And the market was believing it. And guess what? Things not only changed, but the more that they actually changed, the more that it seems actually possible that these rates will go lower. And I'm not even talking about technically. When I look at this fundamentally now, it's like, hold it, man. You know, fundamentally, if we were in Europe and we were running a bank in Europe, what would end up happening, which they are doing, is that they're taking, people are corporations are giving the banks their money, they're paying for that right, and then the banks are in turn running right to the United States. They don't have to run. They hit a button and they're buying our notes and our treasuries because the spread on that is dramatic. You know, if we take a look at the Fed Fund futures rate and what that is, that's specifically traders betting when the next short-term rate hike would be. It's zero for next week, June 15th. You have 20% on the 27th of July. We have 37% on the 21st of September. 41% is the odds on November 2nd. 57% is the first time it goes over 50%, and that is on December 14th. What we also have on June 23rd is the vote in Great Britain whether they want to be in the European Central Union. Now, that's going to be quite a vote. You know, last night I was listening to the yes versus the no's, and it was pretty cool, man, because if folks actually listened to the comments on both sides, it would seem to me that they would leave the European Union, and this is why. So the folks that are saying, including their own prime minister, that are saying that, hey, well, and you got to remember something, that the pound, they never went into the euro. And that was so smart of them, okay, because they didn't give up their pound, all right? What they did do is that they've given up their sovereignty, though, being in the European Union. And so the folks that turn around and say that we can't leave are saying that the trade restrictions will be different. Well, guess what? They don't have to be different, folks, because it's just like all those agreements can be signed, and they don't have to be different. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. And whatever you want in life, folks, visualize it like a nice big motion picture. Step into it, take ownership of it, and fly with it. Thanks for being here, folks. Have a great night, safe night. Look forward to seeing you right here, 8 o'clock tomorrow morning.